Hey, my schmoopity schmoppities. How's everybody doing? It's been a while, huh? I was in Greece for a few weeks, the land of my forefathers, and then I was sick for a couple weeks after I got back, and then, you know, had to get back into the swing of things with work and what have you. Got a promotion, but I work graveyard shift, so it always takes a little adjusting to get back into those hours, but here we are. Last video also had to do with the workshop, and in that one, believe it or not, I cleaned in here. This is the cleanest I can get it. So the final step, I thought, was let's paint. But then I realized before I paint, I want to install the air conditioning unit, and over here in the other room, let's turn on some lights for you. If you see, over there is a black plastic bag covering an opening, and over here behind this piece of wood is another. And I need to take those bags off, obviously, to paint, which means I need to seal the holes. As you can see that one there, the bag is torn. But I need to get all this duct tape and what have you off so I can paint. Which means sealing up the holes to keep any debris, dust, dirt. I do live in the desert, so you can see, like, over time there's all sorts of sand on the floor. So in that regard, rather than painting, the plan for today is finally, this has been my like goal from day one, is get the AC unit in there. And then in that box, I bought some plexiglass that I would like to install over the holes and make them like windows, because this is a closed off room. I want to be able to look outside and see if there's someone in my backyard, or, you know, get a little sunlight or what have you. You know what I'm saying? So for the moment, my plan is to put the plexiglass on the outside of the building. Let me show you what I'm talking about. So this is that one opening behind that piece of wood, right? The idea is to put the plexiglass around the outside with some caulking and I think some self-tappers to hold it in place. Looks like something like that was done before. I know there used to be an ATM in this opening. And then do the same thing on the other side. This way I'll have a little shelf on the inside. I can use that as a shelf to rest things or what have you. But I just think that's the best way to do it. But for the moment, first step is to get this AC put in. Then when I paint, I can just cover the AC and paint around it. All right, so let's get cracking here and release it. Okay. All right, I got my hand truck here ready. Let's head out to the garage where I've had the AC stored for ever. Just unlock this. See if I can do this one-handed. I can. I'm a success. Look at that. There is a cinder block on the other side. My gardener friend put it there for me. Let's get that out of the way. This is an exciting day for me. I bought this AC months ago. There's a whole story behind it too. I'll tell you about it a little bit later in the program. Get my phone out. Got an app on here to open my garage door. Can't see. Hmm. Is it really that dim? Or is my phone just not lighting up? Hang on. My phone was just too dim. All right. Moment of truth. I don't even remember exactly where the AC is. Hopefully it's not buried. I don't think it is though. There we go. Modern technology. It's underneath that tarp. Tarp. There it is. All right. You want to watch me dig all that out? I don't think so. Neither do I. I mean, it's not a big deal. Just take a minute. Let me do it and I'll bring it back. All right, it's all dug out and ready to go. I'll give you some of the info on it. It is an LG air conditioner that does cooling and heating. A buddy of mine at work told me about these. I was planning on doing like a split system, but I didn't have enough room for a separate 220 circuit for one of those. And then he told me that they have these 110 volt window units. And I believe the hole in the building is exactly the same size as this unit, which is one of the main reasons I wanted it. A lot of the other units I saw were bigger and they wouldn't fit, and it would be a little bit of a pain in the ass to open up that hole more if I had to. The other thing I really liked about this is it's got the Wi-Fi symbol on it. It's got smartphone control, so I can put an app on my phone and I can turn this thing on and off when I'm not even here. So let's say I know I want to work in there, I'm on my way home from work, it's a hot day, I can turn on the AC, and when I get home it'll be nice and cool already. I really like that idea. It's a little bit of a pain in the rear to get this thing. I ordered it, only one place online had it. They told me that it was available, I ordered it, then they told me it was not available, then months passed, then they told me that there was a small amount available and I was next on the list, and then I was told it wasn't available and I may have to get a refund, and then the next day I had a shipping notification, so I didn't question it, it was fine, and it arrived. So it's just been sitting here for months and months. Hopefully it works, I'm sure it does. Nice thing too is it's made for 320 square feet. My building is 280 square feet, so I believe it. There should be no issue with heating and cooling. So yeah, I'm pretty stoked. It has a remote control too, which is will be handy. But I really was happy about the 110 volt, the window unit, and more so the Wi-Fi control. All right, let me get it on the dolly and we'll bring it to the back. As I'm pulling it on the dolly along these river rocks, I remember how shitty it is to wheel things across river rocks. So I think in the plan, excuse me, is just to make a path here from the garage, the driveway, through the gate here with some crusher fine, so I have a path to wheel things on. And then here's dirt, which right now it's dry, but when it's wet it's a bit goopy. That's an official term. So I think I'm gonna crusher fine this whole area as well, but that's a little bit later on the list. Okay, here we are. I'm wondering if I can just lift it up there or if I'll need to use my ramp. Let me set things up. Thank you. I wish you could have seen that. These shoes I'm wearing, they have zero traction. So as I was trying to pull the thing up, my feet were just sliding out from under me. All right, we're in. Nice. Very cool. No pun intended. Let me do some setup and we'll see what happens. All right, step one is to get this plastic off of here. Hopefully the duct tape hasn't permanently bonded. You know, sometimes duct tape can do that. All right, let's see. I would, however, like to thank the duct tape and the multiple plastic bags I've had to put here for keeping the weather out as much as possible. You've done a good job, my friends. Let's see what we got. Not bad at all, mostly. All right, that wasn't so bad, was it? I have a couple of spots I'll show you just so you see what I'm looking at. On the inside face here, that's tape residue, but really doesn't matter since the unit will be sitting in there. I am noticing, because of the heat damage or some flex, I may want to fill that in. We'll see. Fill it in with caulk. I might have to take these screws out. We shall see. The other thing I really want to check out is this frame has been floating around in here since day one. I've kind of assumed it fits in here. Am I right? Sorta. Not really. Leaves a big gap in either direction. So I'm gonna call that a no. I wonder if it went where the ATM went. Looks kind of small to me though. Maybe. Ah. No. Also a no. Huh. Interesting. Anyway. We'll save that for another time. Maybe it went there. That's a smaller opening. Should we check? Just out of curiosity? What do you say? Yes? No? It's gonna fit? That window typically, I'm sorry, originally has bars on the inside, which I do have. Oh, look at that. Fits perfectly. Huh. I wonder if they had an AC on this side. Now, I see screw holes here, but not on the outside, so it probably went on the inside. So we'll take a look at that when the time comes. All right. Time to put you on the tripod again. Take some measurements. Like I said, it should fit perfectly, but I want to make sure before I go lifting it and shoving it in the window, and then maybe I'll go around and seal that with some caulk. All right, let me set you up better, and we'll take a look together. Let's take a look inside. This is the anverso. Not to be confused with the reverso. So on the top of the box here, we've got our registration form. We have got our owner's manual and remote control. which did come with batteries. Look at that quality, I tell you. And then we've got the front face of the unit, I assume. Yes, indeed. LG. These are adjustable flaps here. It's got a small filter on the back. I'm assuming that's where the control panel looks out. Some very helpful styrofoam. I don't know if I'm going to be able to lift this thing by myself and put it in the window. What's in here? Stop! Any questions or concerns about your product? Shall we open it up? See what's inside? Can you see? You sure can. You sure can. What do you think's in here? Be careful not to go too deep. Oh, look at that. Little accordion schmishmops. So like if the opening's too big, you accordion. And some weather stripping. How very thoughtful of them. I do have more if I need it. Brackets. Screws and more brackets. Plastic brackets. These are metal brackets. Alright. Any other surprises? Nope. Just the plastic covering the face. And the cord. Alright. What do you think? Do we break the box open like that? Let's do it. I'm confident this will work. One more side. You're in my way. Excuse me. Here she is, because it's a female. Huh. What do you think? You want to take a look? You got the top view. Here's the front view. So that's where that cover's going to go. There's the faceplate. Fortunately, those fins are slightly bent. Not the end of the world, but I will have to be careful of those, as well as that is your thermostat. Similar to, I haven't installed them, but I've seen them for cars. You want a thermostat for your fan. You can mount one similarly. So, let's bust out my tape measure. See what we got. The back width is... This tape measure is horrible, by the way. You want centimeters? 46.8, roughly. Let's see what we got here. Come on. horrible tape measure. Sorry. It's so bad. It really is. Harbor Freight at its finest. You know? It's okay. I love Harbor Freight. It's just sometimes. Don't be sloppy. Alright, jam that in there. What do we got here? 40, oh, 51. So we've got plenty of room there. And then we've got here. Let's let gravity help us. 36 and a little. And here we've got, I got card, styrofoam in my way. Can I do this while holding you up? Just under. Hang on, honeys. You can do it, I swear. Just under 36. So height-wise, we're really good. And then width-wise, we have plenty of room. I think I'm gonna lift it myself and put it in there. Doing my best not to hurt myself or anyone else. And yeah, so the height is nice. It'll be snug. The width is extra. We'll use the, I don't think we'll need those accordion jammies, but I definitely will need some kind of weather stripping. I'll figure that out after the fact. So hang on. All right. I do not want to crush the face of this thing. Do not. Question, this doobobber, oh, you know why? That's where those things slide in. These, the top of this would slide in to that, just like that. Do I put these in? Cover that hole. Let's go outside. See, it's sturdy, right? Yeah, it's not going anywhere. Let's go on the other side. See what's going on. Hello. How cool is that? Guess I could take that piece of tape off. There's that. I thought this would have come with some brackets for here. It did not. I will get some, I guess. So here's the question. The opening here, sides obviously. It's a little, is it canted? No. All right, all in all, I'm happy. It fit well. Can I reach this? Get this tape off of here. I'm on my tippy toes. Alright, I wonder what was so important in there. Unless they knew in shipping that was a crush point. All right, let's go back inside. What an exciting day. Yeah, definitely no brackets. I'll have to get some just to be on the safe side, you know. I could scooch this over that way just a little. Get this out of here for now. I mean, this wouldn't do much but just keep some of the weather out. Do we scooch it over just a little? So it's even. Scooch. There we go. Ah, now the bottom is in better. Like that. So I wonder, how is one supposed to keep this? We don't have earthquakes. All right, you know what? Let me chew on this a little bit and poke around for some of the other weather stripping I have, and I'll bring you back. Okay, here's where we're at after reading the instructions and some contemplation. According to the instructions, before I had put this in place, I should have unscrewed this screw, the same one on the other side, and two in the back. That would release the inner portion out of this outer shell. I could then take this adhesive-backed thin foam, stuck a piece to the bottom sill, stuck a piece to the top sill, then slid the outer case into place. And then, using these screw holes here, you'd screw down into a sill. But obviously I can't do that because this thing was designed mainly for a home, where there'd be a windowsill sticking out. Now, I couldn't see anyone actually drilling into their windowsill, but they're telling you that's more about vibration than anything else. So I may or may not need to do that. If I do need to do that, I could likely just get like a couple of L brackets, or maybe three, and I can screw this thing, unscrew this thing as is at that point, and just pull it out, what have you. We'll see about that. The other thing is, you're then supposed to attach, oh, by the way, I marked the bottoms of these, because when I do pull this thing out eventually, I'll see maybe I can just screw in from there back down, you know, if there's room. The other thing that's then supposed to happen is, hang on, you're supposed to take those accordion thingies, these black plastic pieces attached to the bottom of this, and then the accordion piece slides in on both sides, and then goes to the inside of the windowsill. Again, this would go to the outside, makes no sense. So basically, this is gonna sit the way it is. The nice thing is it's got a little bit of a downward tilt, which I'll show you in the back. There is a place to put a drain plug for humid days if it accumulates water. So what I'm gonna have to do at the very least is get some thick foam, fill this in on both sides. I'll put those thin strips along the bottom and top, and then go into the outside. Take a walk. What I'd like to do, I'm going to take some measurements, and I basically have to get L bracket that goes here and there. It's not supplied. I thought it would be. And I can just screw them right into the wall and then screw into this bottom cover or casing, whatever you want to call it. This rubber plug will come out. This hose plug will go in its place. I could run a hose or just let it drip. So that's what I'm, and then I will need to shove some insulation in here as well. Could I do spray foam? I could. Do I want to? No. But if I just shove foam in there, the elements will get to it. You know, so not sure if I should just get some thick foam, stick it in there, and then I don't know. We'll see. But the thing is, I don't have the time today to go to the store and get the foam, nor get the supports. So I'm gonna leave it as is for the moment. It's closing up the hole well enough, and I will pick up where I left off next week. How's that sound? Okay. Just a couple more things before I sign off for right now. I went into the garage. I have this weather stripping. It's adhesive backed, 3/4 by 5/8. I think 5/8 is the thickness. What I may use that for is, can you see in here this gap where you can see daylight? Right there. That's the gap between the AC unit and the outer casing. And what's the point of, I mean, yeah, that's a big hole right there, but if I weather strip all that, there's still this opening here, so I think I'll take some of this and put it around the bottom, top, maybe the sides as well. So when I remove this from the hole in the wall, take the inner part out, when I slide the inner part back in, it'll seal that up, because I don't think I can just squish it in there with it in place. For the time being, I'm gonna take this stuff that they gave me and just stick some in this opening and in the other opening, just to kind of keep the major crap from coming in for now, just as a stopgap. Get it? Stopgap. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to leave that hole wide open. So, I'm okay with that. Just tear it off there. There you go. Did you catch all that? Let's put that in there. And then I'll see how thick of a foam they do sell. Maybe there is some kind of spray foam I can use that's not, you know, super sticky and permanent like the stuff you normally use, because if I ever do need to remove this thing, gosh, what a pain that would be. The nice thing is I can hypothetically or realistically take the inner part out of the casing once the casing's secure to the wall by just removing these screws here and the two in the back. Right, so that, and then it would just be a matter of getting the casing out. That wouldn't be horrible. Yeah, we'll see. It's just because I have these gaps down here, and it's an irregular shape. I'll go talk to the people at the home center and see what they say. But how about this? Before we walk away, how about we plug it in? Whoa, can you see what I'm doing? You can't, right? I'm doing this. I took that apart. Oh, I may have to break code and turn that upside down. Put my glasses on. I don't know if the circuit breaker's off. There is a reset here and a test on. Nada. He marked it. AC receptacle 10. Ah, it beeped. It make a beeping noise. Okay, I don't see any lights. On. Ooh, fan. Mode. Set to 84. It's stopped blowing. I wonder if it's got to heat itself up, or it's probably 84 or more in here already. That's why. Go higher. Oh, the highest it goes is 86. All right, so it'll be as warm as it is in here right now, which is pretty warm. Then we got E-Saver that saves all the E's. instructions what that means exactly, but yeah, it's an energy save mode. Probably turns itself off when it reaches temperature. But I don't know if it only does it in cooling or heating as well. Let's go to cool. Let's drop this. Year I was born. Fan speed, F1, F2. It didn't change the speed. Maybe it's got to reach. It's not getting cool yet. Let it do its thing. Let it do it. Let it do its thing. I don't have the batteries in the remote. Otherwise, I would try that out. Okay, it's cooling down a little bit. Pretty cool. It's got yeah, so these are that mode, timer, fan speed. Oh, the compressor just kicked in. Oh. Yeah, there it goes, and it picked up pace. Wow, so two fan speeds, that's wonderful. Very nice. I'm gonna see, I think I have a little tool I can try and straighten these out. Ah, it's working. Nice. Can you feel it? I felt it. That's an old commercial. Right on, I'm very happy with that. Okay, let's go back to fan speed 1. And I'm just gonna turn it off for now. I turned it off, it turned itself off. Wow, it works! Huzzah! Very exciting. After how long of wanting to put this in? All right, so we need something to insulate around. We need a couple of L brackets, and we're in business. Maybe eventually I'll make some kind of cover to go around these edges too. I don't know. Might be necessary, might not. More so on the outside than the inside, so the rain doesn't get in. Yeah, and I, like I mentioned, I'm gonna caulk around these edges too. All right, so that's good for now. We'll take a pause and I'll bring you back when I have something more to show you. Okay, sorry for the weird angle. I have a little bit of time left. I'm gonna try and at least prep the plexiglass I got for the openings. I got two sheets, same size. They are 1/4 inch thick by 18 by 24. They're a bronze tint. I was hoping to get a two-way mirror. So no one could look in, but I could look out, but I couldn't find it. I got this from a place called eStreetPlastics.com. I'll put the link on the screen. If you've seen my video about putting yellow plexiglass windows in my Grumman step van, it's the same place I got the plexi. Really happy with them. They're very thorough. You can call them, they'll answer all your questions. Their prices are good, their shipping is fast, so I like them. But what I have to do is peel. There's a protective coating on both sides. Now, what I remember from doing my Grumman windows, it was a nightmare to peel that off, but that might be because they sat around for a long time. I just got these a few days ago, so I want to try and peel them off now. The other thing is I decided initially, my plan was to caulk around these, put them up against the opening, and then use these self-tapper or sheet metal screws or self-tapping screws with these washers I got. Let me show you. They have like a neoprene washer built in, so I figured I could drill a hole in the plexi and then drill these through into the sheet metal of the building, and then the neoprene would give me a seal. But I'm worried about over tightening these and then cracking the plexi. So I was thinking about it, and I think instead of doing this, I'm gonna get some 3M automotive grade double-sided foam tape. They have like 1/2 inch and 3/4 inch wide. And it's kind of thin. It doesn't have to be super thick and spongy. They have thinner one too for like emblems and things like that. Works really well. Obviously it's on your car, so it's on all sorts of environments. I think if I just put a strip along the top and bottom, it's not about sealing more than it is about adhering while the silicone dries. Or of course I could do a perimeter of the 3M tape. I could probably just do that and no silicone as well, because I believe that's waterproof. So I think that's a better way to go, because the more holes I introduce, the more chance for moisture to get in. Also, over tightening this will crack the plexi. So I think the 3M tape is the way to go. I'll save these for a different project. But let's see what we're gonna have here. Hopefully it peels right off, because it's kind of a pain in the rear. I have these plastic razor blades. They're good for removing stickers and stuff from your car. You see how that happens? I hate that. But scrape with the plastic. I also have hot water in here. I have a thing of naphtha too, aka lighter fluid. They tell you not to use something like that, but that's how I got it off the last time. So let's see. I like these plastic razor blades. I didn't know they existed until I was trying to do another project. And I was introduced to them. Obviously they won't scratch like a metal razor blade would. Alright. I'm gonna have at it. At least if I do this today, when I'm ready to install these, I don't have to go through this tedious process. Let me go get a trash bag. And I'll keep going. You can get these on eBay, Amazon. Super handy for doing, if you want to get like bumper stickers off your car, stuff like that. You see what a pain in the ass this is. And it's on both sides of both pieces. So, you get it. So this thing films for 10 minutes and then it shuts off. It shut itself off. So I think I've been doing this for about 15 minutes. I don't know how much of it you caught, but there were patches that just peeled off easily. And then this thing, I had to scrape and scrape and scrape and scrape and scrape with the plastic razor blade. I wish I knew where the holder for this thing was, but I can't find it. But you see here, it left some residue. So if I remember correctly, if I take a little of this naphtha and I put it on a rag, kind of soaking it a little, and then just rub it along the edges, it cleans it right up. The only thing I noticed is once the naphtha dries, you need to definitely use more, of course, but also sometimes it just starts spreading the glue around. I just added more naphtha to my rag. When the rag is wet and fresh, it comes off much more easily. Alright, so that was one side. Got three more to go. Well, I'm going to continue on. You don't need to watch all of that. Hello. Hello. Alright, but that's that. I'll bring you back. Alright, second side's done. Took about a half hour. Here's what it looks like. It was just as difficult as the first side. I gotta wipe it down well. There it is. Nothing, something. It's bronze. I figured it would match. And the idea is to come up here and place it as such, like that, right on the outside. I think that 3M tape will work just fine, and then maybe I could do a bead of caulk around the edges just to be on the safe side, but I think that'll do. What do you think? Nice. It's just to kind of keep the wind out, people from easily peeking in. It's kind of hard. I'm looking through it, but now then again, there are no lights on. But I like it. I'm gonna clean up the other one just so they're ready, and then when I can go to the store, get the brackets for the AC, the insulation for the AC, and the 3M double stick foam tape for this stuff, we can just knock it out. All right, so you guys hang in there. It'll be a split second for you. It'll be a few days for me. Hey, I wanted to give you guys a bit of an update. I'm on the second window here. This one is proving to be a real pain, really difficult, to the point where I even called the company and asked them any advice. They said try warm soapy water, but all that did is it peeled off like the topmost layer of the paper, but I got paper and glue here. However, now that it's drying, I find if I take a towel and I just start kind of rubbing it, the glue starts folding up, and it's making it easier to get. You see that? So in the end, the warm soapy water, letting it soak in, now it's kind of dried off a bit. I think it's better if you soak it in and then peel the top layer off and then let it dry a bit, and then just start abrading it like a kitchen towel. You don't want to use sandpaper, obviously, or anything like that, but this is abrasive enough. It's got texture, but it's not going to harm the glass or the plexi. So let's see if this keeps working. It's the best result I've had thus far. I did try some lighter fluid on it too, and it just got really goopy, and then I just had to keep pouring more and more lighter fluid on there. Just doesn't seem like the best method, but this is working really, really well. I might use the lighter fluid like on these edges where it's really stuck on, but we'll see. I'm gonna keep doing this. I just thought I'd give you the tip in case you order plastic. They were nice enough too. They said if I have too much trouble getting it off, they'd replace the plexi for me, which was really nice. I think I don't need to go that far, but it just goes to show you the integrity of this company. So I would definitely keep using them for projects. All right, I'll bring you back. I'm done with the second one too. I mean, it needs a good cleaning, but I got all the glue and paper off. It was difficult, even more so than the other one. I'm glad that's done, because now all I have left to do is adhere them. And the more I think about it, the 3M double-sided tape idea is the way to go. It's going to be easy, clean, not messy, and it'll protect it from the elements getting in, as well as keeping it in place. And then I will figure out how to insulate around the air conditioner, and that'll be that. Okay, so stay tuned. I'll be back in a bit. All right, everybody, it's a week later, and gonna put in the acrylic windows and then take care of the AC. Let's do the windows first. What I ended up getting was this 3M double-sided tape. It's auto, it's advanced, it's super strength molding tape. I wanted the 3/4 inch wide. They only had 1/2 inch in stock. So I got, I need 13 feet and some inches. So I got 3 5-foot rolls of the 1/2 inch. So what we're gonna do today is Clean the perimeter of this with some isopropyl alcohol. Could also use a naphtha like I did last time. I just don't want to use it all up. Once this is clean, I will install the tape. And because this is going to be the top of the window going into that opening, I want the first piece of tape to run corner to corner. This way when the rain goes down, it will hit the top of that tape rather than stopping the tape here and then running another piece. And there'll be a gap right there. I mean, I'll put them right next to each other, but nonetheless, right? So, yeah, that's it. And then we'll tackle the air conditioner. Let me put you on the tripod and we'll get started. Main reason you would want to use alcohol or naphtha is they do not leave any residue behind, and they evaporate quickly. If you were to use something like a carb cleaner, besides that it may affect the acrylic, that leaves a residue, or it can, some of them do. Residue is bad. Xanadu is good. All right, that's good. Let's get started with this. This stuff is great. It's what you would use if you had like the emblems on your car. You could put them on there. It's thin, right? And it's super sticky. Does a really good job. So I'm going right to the edge. If you don't press it down really hard, you can kind of lift it up. And then once it's on there, press it down. Right up to the other piece. Oops. Scheiße. It slipped. Do this side. Slightly pressing until I know it's in place, then I'll go back, press it on nice and hard. I'm gonna run out on the bottom here. But I think that's okay, because I'll have the coverage from here and the sides. I just didn't want to run out at the top. Dang it. stretched, so it came on stuff. The stuff is stretchy too. Once you take the red backing paper off, it's stretchy. So you want to try not have that happen. Okay. Go on to the next. Putting it right up against the other piece so they touch. Just gonna press it down nice and hard so I make sure it adheres well. Alright, that was good. Pretty straightforward, except for there. And that does happen. Alright, next step, let's get a good measurement here. 24, and then here is 15 and a half. Now let's go over to the building. So now we're going to measure here. This is about 20, so I want 2 inches on either side. The only thing I have to take into account is this cover that I put on a million years ago. It just clears it. Alright, so I can use that as my guide, I guess. There and there. You see through my fat head? 24. And then we had 15, that's 12. So I want an inch and a half here. I'm just making a mark. So basically, show you. I'm going to connect those. Just to give me an idea where to place the window. Right? About 2 inches here. Just right up against that. I'm going to go just a little less. Underneath. Less. All right, those can just be my marks. I'll use that. I won't be able to see the top one. So let me do this. Have to mark all 4 sides. Now, alcohol. It's taking some of the paint off. Interesting. Mostly have to make sure I'm getting the edges where the tape is going to be. It is wiping my mark just a little, but I can still see it. All right. Now we go back to the table. Now we start peeling the backing off carefully. You don't want to touch it with your fingers too much where it's sticky, of course, because you don't want to get your finger oils on there, make it any less sticky. Okay. The nice thing about this stuff is it's, once it's adhered well, it's weatherproof, temperature proof, of course, up to a certain amount. But imagine, you know, this is on your car. Heat, cold, rain, snow, hail. There we go. Last one. Come on. It helps if you have nails. There we go. Almost ready. Now we'll go back to the window, the opening. All right. Carefully try not to place it. Just line it up as best I can without adhering it. Where are you? There you are. Right there. It's a warm day, which is nice because the building's warm. We had rain the last 2 days, which wouldn't have been good. That's on. That's really all it takes. I'll put some pressure on here. These edges are sharp, so I don't want to run my hand along. And then if I feel like I need to, but I don't think I will, I could run some caulking. Another thing I could do is, you know, trim this out with some trim so it looks like a framed window, so it's not just so abrupt. But yeah, there it is. I've been waiting almost 2 years. Is that when we last first started? Get these on here. Nice. Looks level enough. Okay, I'm happy. Let's do the other one and then we'll see what they look like from the inside. I took the liberty of marking this out and putting the tape on the other one because you've already seen me do that. We'll just install it. Right, I'm happy with that. It's nice to put these finishing touches, you know, after a long time of working on stuff. And I do think it might look nicer, yeah, if I frame it eventually. So the two windows are done. This one came out much straighter. The other one's ever so slightly crooked. I'm a little bummed about it, but it's okay. This one was easier because the edges line up with these vertical lines in the building. All right, let's go inside and see what it looks like. All right, let's go inside. Lights are off. Oh, would you look at that? Nice. There we go. Some sunlight. I mean, not enough that it's going to brighten the place up in the sense that I'm not counting on that light for work. But it's always good to have a little extra light. And also, if I'm working in this room, because there were no other windows, I can see if somebody comes into my backyard. I can see out that window, and from here I can see the hot tub area and the patio area, just in case. You never know, someone might come inside. How nice, I have windows. That's so cool. I haven't had windows in here before. Okay, last but not least is to insulate around the air conditioner. I'll show you what I got for that and we'll get cracking. All right, so here we are. I did some research online and I think my best choice was getting some of this stuff. It's window and door expandable foam. The reason for getting the window and door one versus the like filling the gaps one is this will not expand a whole heck of a lot, so there's no worry about it putting pressure on things it shouldn't be putting pressure on. As well, it remains a little bit flexible, so with the heat and cold changes, it should move a bit. In the end, this is not a door or a window, so maybe this was overkill, but I still think it'll do what I need it to do. The plan is to spray it. We have a bit of a ledge in there. I'm gonna try and spray it like at the halfway point up or down, because when this hardens, the outside shell of that is actually sealed. If you cut it, like, it can open up the it's not as good at keeping the weather out, right? So if I go about halfway in, let that harden, then I can go from the outside and fill up what's left. But even if I cut it from the outside then to smooth it out, it will still have the weather seal property like in the halfway point, so that will be fine. The tricky part's going to be the top. There's not a whole lot of room. There's no room from the outside, so I'm not quite sure. I might have to tilt this down, spray, and then tilt it back up and let it kind of, I don't think this hardens immediately, right? It takes a little while, so I can spray up there and then push the thing back into place and let it harden and dry that way. The other thing is I found these brackets. There's two of them. There's the other one. And instead of bolting this from the outside, I think I'm gonna put it on the inside. See this mounting hole there? It fits perfectly, just like that. And it kind of matches the color of the AC as well. I think I will, I may bolt it down now. I might wait till after I paint, because I don't want to paint these. I don't think so anyway. So I might put them in temporarily, take them out when I paint and put them back. But yeah, that worked out really well, just for some extra stability. All right, so let me, never really used this stuff before. I'm a little hesitant to just have at it, but then again, I have to just have at it. So let's do that. Sorry, I forgot to start filming. I already spray foamed the top, got up on my ladder, tilted this forward and just kind of sprayed a bead in there as best I could. And I'll get this area as best I could. All right. I'm thinking, now that the top's done, I may install these to keep it from moving. And then I'll go around. No, I'm not going to do that, because it'll be in the way. All right, let's keep going. Oh, I'm happy with that. I'm quite happy with that as well. Let's get the bottom. No. This works well. You have good control. You're not supposed to get this on your skin, so hence wearing gloves. I am wearing shorts though, and it got on my legs. Wasn't that expensive either. I don't remember the exact price, but it wasn't too bad. Let me check the top again. I like it. Let's go outside. From the spring I just did inside, you see how much it came out? It's funny, it expanded this way more than that way. Underneath, do a little more there. I have to get in these corners because the unit, how it's sitting in that casing, there's a big gap there. All right, let's set you up. Let's go. Nice, I'm happy with that. Oh, something's biting me. There we go. Doesn't expand like crazy, so I can try and fill gaps, which I like. And let's see what I could do on the top, if anything.
I'll do a bead. Very thin.
Here, let me show you. You have pretty good control with this stuff. So I'm just gonna do a very, very thin bead on top because there's not really much of a gap. Here you go. See what I'm looking at? Oh, let me zoom you out, sorry. So, there's really not much of a gap here, but I just wanna put a very thin, I'm gonna go slowly, more slowly. And I don't mind if that shows. I still have brown paint, exterior paint. I could cover it up if I need to. All right, I'm okay with that. Oops, I messed it up because that's just how I do things. I can't leave it alone. I want to try and smooth it out, but this isn't designed to smooth out. All right. Let me, there we go. That's good. I think, oh, therefore I fall. I think I'm okay. That's where I wanted to get in. I did. We're okay there. Maybe a little squirt right there. Nice. I want to clean this tip off. This stuff is very sticky. I'm gonna wipe it in the dirt. Get it off my hands. Get it off my ladder. All right. Maybe I'll try. Just under here. Just like that. Kind of connect it. Now I'm just having fun. I'm okay with that. I want to fill that in just so moisture can't collect on a ledge. You know what I mean? Nice. I see a little gap right there. I'm happy. This was so much easier than trying to stick little wads of foam. I'm good with that. I just want to get this right there, like that. Normally you can come back and cut around this when it dries. I may not. Little gap right there. Okay, leave it alone, dude. So, I'm not pointing where I'm working. Okay, I need to stop. I just want to double check. Because the bottom of this has a contour. You know, I just want to make sure it got in everywhere it needed to. Okay, I think I have plenty left. Let's go take a peek inside again. Make sure it's where it needs to be. All right. Fill in just a little. Nice, I'm glad I can see through like this gap right here. There's no sunlight coming in anymore because that's where I was insulating right now underneath that, remember? And remember I had spoken about maybe caulking this gap But because I'm using this, there is no need to do that. But I will foam to the edge. I will cut this when it dries. Wow, pretty cool. On top, we are how we are. I think that's it. I'm quite happy. I do see daylight right there. Do I caulk in there on the back side? I think I'm gonna have to. See a little bit there, all the way around. Here, let me go back outside and see about that. That's where the actual AC unit slides into the housing itself. Yeah, I don't have access. Okay, I guess it'll be a little bit not energy efficient. I think that'll be okay though. Is there any way to get it on this side? I do not. I will not stick my straw in there. I should. Do I do it? I did it. Let's try it in there too. As far as it'll go. And a quick spurt. A little bit more. Because I can't really see. All right. Just don't want to get it on the coils or anything. You know what I mean? It will make it difficult too if I ever want to slide this out. But it's okay. I'll deal with it. Trying not to press too hard on the trigger. It might sound like it is. A lot of it's just like the thing that the propellant. All right, folks, I think we're done here. Now I just have to let it sit and dry. I'm happy with that. I got everywhere that had any gaps that I could see got sealed. The camera stopped. But I was just saying, I sealed everywhere I can see. There's a couple of little spots. Like if I peek through there, there's some daylight. But I just can't get in there. And I really think it'll be okay. I don't want to start filling this whole thing around the coils and the condenser and stuff. You know, I think it'll be fine. That one little spot of daylight's not going to ruin me. Although I'll be thinking about it because that's just how I am. There's some more there. But that's okay. All right, let's let that set up. Once that's done, I will trim around here. I think I will use either a razor knife, or you can also use like a hacksaw blade, just a blade. And then I can put the brackets on, pop the cover on. And we're done and we're ready for paint. All right, let's wait for that to dry. It's been 8 hours. I should have just enough sunlight left to do this. Only hacksaw blade I have, and it's bent and broken. But it's okay. Doesn't need to be perfect. Close to it. But not perfect. There we go. Now you see how I was mentioning, when you tear that off, it gets all cellulose-y, but because I sprayed it from the inside first, it won't be like that. halfway through or so. So I'll still have good coverage. You know, and it's not like it's gonna absorb the water or anything. It's just that you want it to be that hard and smooth part would be better. Okay, I'm gonna go around and do the same all the way around. The wind's really picking up. It's about 8:15 p.m. It's my second of my 2 days off. I just wanted to get this done. I don't know what happened here. I don't know where that came from. Scheiße. My paint. It's okay. I have more paint. Peeled it off. Oh. Now, if you were doing this on a nice interior wall in a house, you would take different steps. Ooh, my kilt's flying up, and I'm not wearing anything. Hello, neighbors. Shit. Thankfully, they can't see me that much. Talk about flashing the neighbors. Opa. Now I just totally flashed them. Hang on. Modesty crisis averted. So, can you see there? Or their light, right? There is foam on the inside, but there's that too. I may stick the hose in that hole and fill. I don't like that very much. And this peeling paint, like it's just peeling. Like it didn't ever bond to the metal. Oh well. I don't have many options. I just want to get this part done tonight so I can call it done and then move on next weekend, hopefully, to painting. I was mentioning, if you were going to do this like on a nice painted wall, you would have taken other precautions. But being my outdoor workshop, I want it to be nice. But I didn't mind having some left over on the AC or something. Did I mention I was just taking a nap? Working graveyard shift changes your whole routine. All right, I'm all right with that. Let's go inside. All right, I finished outside and I did take the can. It still works, just have to shake it up a bit. And those three, four spots I saw where I could see daylight through the foam, I just shoved the nozzle through there and hit the spray button again. Now I'm not gonna do the top, the very top, because of its kind of precarious position, let's say, because it there wasn't much room up there. I kind of had to move the unit to get it up there, you know what I'm saying? Remember? So I'm gonna leave it as is. Plus I can't see up there normally. Really matter. Out of sight, out of mind. Nice. gotten off really easily. I'm happy about that. Other than, you know, where it peeled the paint a bit, which again is not that big a deal. Man, big voids in there. All right, let's get this side, lefty. All right, back to righty. I cut it this way first, so if I go a little too deep with the this cut that I just did, it won't pull it all out too deeply inside. This is just because of that screw head. Nice. They say this stuff cleans up with acetone. Oh, there's a big void in there, so I may do the same just to make sure. I mean, it's sealed, but you know. It's deceiving too, how you think with all this overspray and the nature of this stuff that it would not have those types of voids, but it does. So it's a good lesson for you. Last bit. Nice. I'm happy. We're insulated. All right. There we go. Just kind of scraping it off the AC housing. All right. Couple of big voids in there. Let me just spray those real quick and then we call it done. Done. This is the same thing I did outside. I got the can. The handy nozzle fits in that hole. I'm spraying. Not too much, because it's just going to come out again. It's going to expand. The stuff expanded more than I thought. So as we were waiting, it did expand. When I was waiting for it to dry, those 8 hours. Keep that in mind. I'll have some cleanup to do there again, in other words. Just filling in big air pockets. I think this can's just about had it. All right, I'm calling that done. Done. I will have a little cleanup to do. See, can you see up there how it is? But that's fine. That's gonna stay like that because, again, the nature of how it had to seal that gap. Right on. Yeah, you see how that's expanding a bit? But that's all right. That'll be a real quick final cleanup. Well, folks, AC is in, AC is insulated. We got our windows in. Oh, check this out. So remember this afternoon, these were, you couldn't really see through them too much from the outside looking in. Well, with that light on, here's what you get from the outside. You can see right in. Which isn't bad, because that light won't be on unless I'm in there. I may make some kind of curtain or covering. But it's nice to have it sealed from the wind and the elements. And that's why I needed to do this first, because if I painted first, I would have had to take the plastic bags off that were covering these holes, and they'd just be wide open after I painted. So now they're covered. We can paint. And that is like the last major step. I have a couple of little odds and ends. Gonna need to replace this doorknob with a new one that locks, and we need a knob here. But this door doesn't even completely seal because of the fire. It closes, but it won't close past this. I think, you know, if I got a new door, I think the bottom just kind of twisted out because of the heat. But it's okay, that's fine. I don't need it to completely seal shut. The fact that it stays open on its own is fine. Yeah, and then after that, the painting's done. This gets mounted to the wall. It's like a little table thing. It may be in the way ultimately, but I just kind of liked it. And there are some bars that go over there, and I'm going to get a fan to put over those louvers. That's going to be my exhaust fan. I've been looking for a louvered vent like that where you can open and close them all with one movement, like move a rod and they all open and close, because the slats on the outside and on the inside move. The inside ones are vertical, the outside ones are horizontal, but it ends up you have to move each one individually. Kind of a pain, but that's okay. I'll just open them, the outside ones, and close the inside ones. And when I need ventilation, I'll open the inside ones and turn the fan on. But that's it, really. Those are little things we'll get done after we paint. All right, folks, thanks for playing. Thanks for watching. If you want to come over and help me clean all this crap up so that I can paint, you're more than welcome. Otherwise, I will see you soon. And hopefully this place will be done and we can get to work finally. Pretty exciting. There we go. Reminds me of pudding. You all take care. Bye bye. I thought you might like to see what it looks like with the front cover on. I haven't snapped it totally into place because I will remove that when I'm painting. Maybe, or I'll just plastic bag the whole thing. But yeah, looks nice. These louvers move. The vertical ones go left and right. This whole thing moves up and down. All right, we've got temp settings for heat and for cool. E-saver, it lets you save lots of E's. Lets you know when to clean your filter if you're hooked up to the Wi-Fi. I guess you can set a timer on it too. A couple of fan speeds. I did try it out one day just to make sure it turned on. Everything was good. So it's a think.